Hey y'all, it's Laura, and I am back with a layout for acherryontop.com. Now, this is a blog hop layout, so not only do I have this video for you, I also have a blog post, which if you follow my blog at takingascenicroute.com, you know that I don't post every week even. Usually it's a couple times a month, just some projects that I want to highlight, things that I had really fun making and want to add more detail to. So this is going to be one of those projects, and as you can see, I took the cover of the Let's Stay Home collection from Pinkfresh, cut it down, and I'm going to use it as a backdrop for my photo. So starting with some of this Tim Holtz Speckled Egg, which is the brand new color that he just released in the Distress Oxide ink. And all of us in this blog hop are using this brand new color on our layouts. Well, I'm using it through a Vicky Booten stencil. Sorry, the camera does shake just a little because I am actively getting it through that stencil the best I can, but I have marked where my little backdrop piece from the cover is going to go so that I know how to cover just behind it, create a frame for it, if you will, using this stencil. Now, one of the things I really, really enjoy about this process is it doesn't have to be perfect because a lot of it is going to be covered up. It's in the background, and that's the beauty of something really simple like this type of mixed media through a stencil is it's going to be in the background. If you make a little error, you can always cover that little bit up and it's totally fine. That's my favorite way to use mixed media, is in a way where I know a lot of it's going to be covered up and it's just going to be peeking around the edges of the design, because that means if I make a mistake, I don't have to throw away that paper and start over. I can just simply cover it up. And it's really super easy. So once I get this whole stencil area framed in, I'm going to lay my cover piece on top and we'll just start building. Now this photo that I'm using today is really, really cute, from December in 2017. And I am scrapping that year at the moment. And it's a really, really funny photo. My kids had found the Christmas tree box, which we had gotten out to put the Christmas tree in, to put it away. And the three of them decided to climb in and sit and watch TV while sitting in this little box, which absolutely cracked me up. I just thought it was so funny that they just assumed, like, there's a box and they're in it. I mean, I expect this from Sophia because I'm pretty convinced that one of my twins is part cat, but she sees a box, she's in the box. There's no question. She's gotten into gift bags, she's gotten into Tupperware containers. I mean, if she fits, she sits. That's all there is to it. And it was just really funny to see all three of them piled into this box and just happily sitting together watching TV. Just absolutely cracked me up. So now that I've got my background ready to go, and this is a great way to use the packaging on any Pinkfresh Studio collection because all of them have this kind of sampler in the front, and it's great to just cut it out and either use it as a background or you can cut out the individual pieces and make a grid layout. I mean, it's just such a really cool thing when you can use the packaging too, and so I was really excited to do that. Now, always I map my photos on white cardstock. It's just an effect I really like. I think it helps to add a little bit of definition to your photo and really pop it up off of the background so that it grabs lots of attention. Now I'm going to dig into the ephemera and just pull out little bits and pieces to try in different places. At first, I was really just looking for a title. And then as I came across other little pieces, I realized I could frame some of those grid pieces with some teeny tiny little frames that are in the ephemera pack, as well as add some little embellishments inside of those grid pieces and just kind of give them a little bit of a 3D look. Of course, I'm going to add a journaling spot because y'all know I love to journal on my layouts, and I will add a little bit in there. Not a ton, because honestly, this isn't one of those long story situations. This is just a really cute photo, a sweet moment that the three of them just piled into this box and just decided to sit and watch TV together. It's just really cute. And I have a variety of that type of thing in my scrapbooks as well. So I have things that have longer stories, and then I have things that's like, this is just a really cute moment. So now you see I'm adding those pieces into the grid. Any grid that was open got an ephemera piece. And some of the grids that are even partially covered up, I just had a little piece peeking out just to give it a little bit more interest and keep it from being Okay, it's just the background. I also have these teeny, teeny, tiny little pieces for my scattering that I'm going to add around the outside edge, especially in places where the stenciling has little gaps, because that's going to happen. And what did I say? You cover it up, right? So that's what I'm doing here. I'm going to bring in some puppy stickers. I'm going to bring in, again, more of those teeny, tiny little pieces. I'll use a sticker from the cardstock sticker sheet under my title, and then just adding lots of scattering. So that's my scattering this time, is with these cute little bitty bitty shapes that I mostly cut from the 6x6 paper pad. I am obsessed with fussy cutting lately. I love to fussy cut anyway, but with how stressful this time has been, this has been my absolute relief from that stress, is cutting up the little bits and pieces and using them as ephemera on my layouts is just so easy. It's so nice to do watching TV, watching a YouTube video, and I can be actively doing something while I'm watching. And when I go to scrap, it's so much easier because I have all these fun little bits and pieces already cut out and I can just lay them down, which is exactly what I'm doing here. I really like how this one turned out. I wasn't sure where it was going in the beginning. I just had the idea of using it. And then I brought in the navy blue Nuvo drops. These are crystal drops, and I'm going to use those for my controlled splattering all around the page, mostly on those little bits that I've added around the outside, but even on some of the inside pieces as well, just for a little bit of fun. I really prefer these to enamel dots because A, they're not as big as enamel dots, and they're also not as hard. And so they don't create dimension, not heavy dimension on your pages, because I want small ones anyway. Then coming in with my uncontrolled splattering with Heidi Swap Color Shine to finish it off. Always finish my layouts with scattering and splattering. That's it for this one. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please check out the blog post. And until next time, bye guys.